right, ladies and gentlemen, it's the Bearded Brewer. We're at the point that everybody, well, whoever really cared, are waiting to see the system up and running again. They're currently putting the hot liquor temp to set at 163, so 67 degrees. See, we're heating up. So, we're at 67 degrees right now and climbing. It's going to be a little while until we get to that point. But what we're going to do is we're going to do Mike Dean's from Deanless. We're going to do the pale ale. Okay, a little update here. We're on 128 degrees on the liquor tank. We're getting there. Get about a little over 20 gallons of water in there. So as we get the right temp, put 4 gallons over into the mash tun. And then what we'll do is we'll put all that deliciousness, which that right here. Get 12 ounces of special roast, 1 pound of carapils, which my home brew shop calls it dextrin, 8 ounces of honey malt, 1 pound of Munich, 8 pounds of gold pilled Vienna, 2 ounces of footballs. These can't go with these. And then the starter that I've got in the house is pretty shit. So. Well, yeah. Alright, so we're at 163 degrees on the hot liquor tank. So I'm going to go ahead and do, I'm going to transfer 4 gallons of water into the mash tun. Add my tablespoon of pH 5 stabilizer. Get it all nice and stirred up, mixed up. About 1.2 I believe it's 1.2 quarts. I don't know, it ends up coming to be like 4 gallons total of water for the amount of grain. So I'm gonna make it a little bit, probably right around in the middle as far as consistency. So once we get that all situated and ready to go, we'll lower the temperature on the hot liquor tank to about 152-153 degrees. Once we get it down to that temperature, then what we'll do is then we'll start getting the mash going. Special roast. Crystal 30. Carapels. Mm-hmm. honey malt. And then gold pilsner. Okay. So now we're rolling. Putting that beautiful goodness, trying to get her up to temperature. We're at 138 degrees, so we gotta get it up to 152. We'll have it set cooler. So, cover her up. But what we got going on here? Coils that are inside. That's where the water is circulating around those coils. Now the wort, well not wort yet, but the mash is coming through a screen into the pump, into the bottom of that coil, circulating into the 152 degree temperature water. Okay, we are at 152 degrees in the mash time. So, hot liquor tank sitting at 156, setting for 154. So the HLT element is on, that'll fire when needed, and then it will keep the mash temperature at 152. So we're set for 60. So here we go. Getting this beautiful nectar. Tank 170. We're slowly introducing that warmer or hotter water out of the hot liquor tank. It's coming out of the tank, going into the pump, to the top of the pump, into the bottom of the coil, and then it's coming through the top of the coil. So essentially, it rinses out the coil through the top. Mash time. leave myself a nice little pool. About an inch, I'd say, above the grain. And I'm pulling out of the mash tun, going down into the pump at the top, and then to the bottom. So we're going to need about, let's see, I'm going to go about 8.5 gallons into the boil kettle. Once we get to that point, we'll get a roll. 12. Start adding some hops. We're well on our way. Alrighty, we are done with filling up the bowl kettle. So we're about 8.75. That should be pretty good. Not too bad on the extras. Starting to heat up. Up to 177 and climbing. Looking for the boil point, 212. So once we get this going, then we'll add a half ounce of East Kent Goldings. Boil that for 40 minutes, and we'll add some Fuggles. So as soon as we get this thing in a rolling boil, we'll give you another update. All right, we're about 12 minutes left to go. I just did the second hop addition. It's having a little issue with some condensation, so I had to put a fan over there to blow it out. I figured in the garage I wouldn't have that problem, but evidently we do. So it looks like about a gallon and a half, give or take, evaporation. So it's not doing too bad. Got about 2 more minutes. We'll be doing the last hop addition, 1 ounce of Fuggles, and then we're gonna chill her down. Okay, we got 2 minutes to go. So the way we have this set up now, it's gonna come out of the boil kettle, down into the pump, underneath into my counterflow chiller. Now the water is gonna come in through the bottom. Wort is going to go through the top, counterflow. There's a thermometer down there, so I'll keep watching it, put it in the bucket. Looks like I've lost another half a gallon. So it's definitely getting rid of some water. So we got about a minute or so to go. And whenever we get to that point, I'll be right back. All right, here we go. We are now coming out of the boil kettle. Matter of fact, I'm not even pulling through a pump yet. And we are at 120 and dropping. We're down to 100. About 92 degrees, so Okay, well.
Turn on the pump, pinch it down.
Just gravity it, but
after that, it's time to pitch the yeast. So this ends the brew day on the Dreher Abomination Vienna Pale Ale. Thanks, Mike Dean.